This week on All Star Wrestling, we will see the personification of Polish power, Ivan Putski, returning to action. Also scheduled, the big butcher near 300 pounds, a Luau Battles butcher, Paul Vachon. Hello, everyone. My name is Vince McMahon, welcoming you to another edition of All Star Wrestling. And also scheduled, I might add, two tag team matches, one in which we'll be seeing the combination that really the entire wrestling world is buzzing about concerning the two chiefs, Peter Maivia and the honorary Indian chief, Jay Strongbow. Also scheduled in a non-title tag team event, the tag team champions, Mr. Fuji and Professor Taru Tanaka. All of this and more in addition to the fact that Larry Zbyszko will be battling the heart punch specialist, the former Worldwide Wrestling Federation champion, Stan the Man Stasiak. We shall return with the opening contest as we continue in just a few moments.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to All Star Wrestling, promoted by Phil Zatko, supervised by the State Athletic Commission, and the officials assigned, the Chief Deputy Commissioner in charge, Nick Santoro, the doctor in attendance at ringside, Dr. Michael Tedesco, the timekeeper at the bell, Mike Mittman, and the referees for this hour of wrestling, Dick Worley, Wee Willie Weber, and my name is Jim McHugh. The opening contest, a tag team match. It is scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Here in the corner to my left, from Brooklyn, New York, weighing 220 pounds, it is Jose Estrada. And his partner from New York City, weighing 239 pounds, it is the unpredictable Johnny Rods. And in the corner to my right, from the Isle of Samoa in the South Pacific, weighing 275 pounds, introducing High Chief Peter Maivia. And his partner from Pawhuska, Oklahoma, weighing 247 pounds, Chief Jay Strongbow.
Oh, Johnny Rods. Making a move over there on Peter Maivia. It looks like it's going to be Rod squaring off against Maivia to open up things here. And here we go. Johnny Rods in the corner, locking up now with Chief Maivia. Maivia backed into the not-so-neutral corner, as you can see here. Jose Estrada assisting Johnny Rods. Referee finally coming over and breaking it up. Maivia still in that corner. And Jose Estrada hammering away. Johnny Rods now by way of the top rope, down into the back. Maivia starting to exchange a few blows there a moment ago with Jose Estrada. But then Johnny Rods put it into that. Maivia with a leg out over the rope. Rods again from down into the midsection. Look at that maneuver by Peter Maivia, though, trying to escape. And does indeed do just that by way of tagging Jay Strongbow. Might be a taking a rest as Jay Strongbow is backed into the corner now. Tag was made, and once again, Rods comes in off the top rope. Strongbow hammered into the corner, hammering down to the midsection, and Jay Strongbow going on the warpath. Oh! Fabio holding on to the tights of Johnny Rods. And Jose Estrada says hello to his partner. Strongbow again with Jose Estrada ramming him into Rods. And Rods was not going to take it that time. Dissension among the ranks. Oh, my goodness. And humiliation upon that. My view, getting the whole crowd here riled up a bit. Oh, Johnny Rods now. We'll see what his partner can do against Jay Strongbow. Strongbow with fancy footwork. One of the things that's carried Jay Strongbow. Look at that. From behind, Rods tried to attack Jay Strongbow. Moved out of the way. Dodging his man, Maivia comes over to help out. Uh-huh. And Strongbow may chase Rods all the way back to the dressing room. Strongbow over there next to Johnny Rods, and Rods took full advantage of it. Snaps him down from the top rope. Jose Estrada pounding across the back of Strongbow. You can bet Rods will not help at all. Double team effort now. And apparently the referee is going to allow Johnny Rods to continue hammering away on Jay Strongbow. Tagman and Maivia. Ready. Look at him. Off the rope, Maivia with him. Ooh, boy. Maivia putting knots on the head of Johnny Rods. And Rods has no idea where he is. Johnny Rods getting a pretty rough going over here in this match. Now tagging Jose Estrada. Estrada clearly not in the same category as Maivia, for that matter, Jay Strongbow. Tag made Strongbow over the top rope. Whipped to the ropes, now coming off Jose Estrada. There's a sleeper hold. Maivia chasing Johnny Rods round and round. Jose Estrada may have gone 9-9. Rods with a cheap shot, but Maivia simply walks over the prone tag team partner of Johnny Rods, Jose Estrada.
It is the time, 6 minutes and 25 seconds. The winners, High Chief Peter Maivia and Chief J. Strongbow.
Strongbow and Maivia victorious again, and Jose Estrada is just flat out on the canvas. Referee demanding Strongbow awaken. His opponent, Strongbow, reluctant to do so. Although bear in mind, certainly Peter Maivia has the ability to awaken an opponent, and for that matter, the ability to put him to sleep as well. Maivia says, nah, don't wake him up, let's go home. Let's hang around here. Let's see if indeed the referee insists on Strongbow and Maivia waking up Jose Estrada. Oh! Rods almost found himself asleep as well. Estrada, nope. Jose Estrada, woo! Awakened rather rudely there by Peter Maivia, and Maivia simply waves to him. Bye-bye. We shall return, ladies and gentlemen, with the Polish power. Ivan Putski, don't go away.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next bout is set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Here in the corner to my left, from Catania, Sicily, weighing 245 pounds, here is the continental nobleman, Joe Tucko. And here in the corner to my right, from Krakow, Poland, weighing 280 pounds, here is the Polish Power! Well, there you heard it from him, ladies and gentlemen, the Polish Power, Ivan Putski.
Putski against Joe Tucko, and here we go. Putski backed up against the rope there by Joe Tucko. Forearm smash. Putski quickly reaching for him. Didn't like that tactic. Tucko again with another forearm smash and quickly backing away. Tucko unquestionably knows of the power of Putski and certainly respects it. Dick Worley is not one of the most popular referees as far as Joe Tucko is concerned. A moment ago, it was more than a gesture than anything else. It was Worley kind of pushing a little nudge there. Joe Tucko, tell him to go out and get him. Starting to wrestle. Putski threatening to hammer the nose of Joe Tucko. Tucko trying to reach for some hair. Whoa, my goodness. Tucko, justifiably to a certain extent, reluctant to tie up with Ivan Putski. Tucko apparently wanted referee Dick Worley to feel the knots. Putski appears to be having a good time in here, or at least it did for a moment there, but not right now. Look at him. Squinch all up, the bull. He is as powerful as a bull, this Putski. Ooh. Putski appears to be somewhat angered. There's a look at some of the Lilliputians around. Come from all places and all different sizes and shapes and ages. Making professional wrestling one of the biggest spectator sports in the world today. Putski there, grasping his hands, massive hands. Look at his shoulders and upper arms of Putski. Oh! Putski not too happy at this moment, I don't believe. Turco going round and round, stepping through the ropes. Putski saying, come on out. Does not want to be suckered in the corner there by Joe Turco. Well, respecting someone's ability is one thing, but it looks like Turco is downright afraid. Putski with his arms up in the air and that forearm smash to the chest is just going to get him angered. Right into the bear hug. Yes, sir, Ray, it's over. Turco. Under the bear hug, submitting. And boy, I'll tell you, the power of Putski is really something to see.
Here is the time, ladies and gentlemen. 4 minutes and 51 seconds. Here is your winner, the Polish Power, Ivan Putski.
Putski victorious. We shall return with an interesting interview, so stay with us. To my right, ladies and gentlemen, this tag team combination unquestionably needs very little introduction, if any. Jay Strongbow, Peter Maivia. A tag team combination that I might add, Jay, that has captured certainly the interest of every wrestling fan in America today, for that matter, the world. You fellas, on an individual basis, ranked among the greats, and together, well, I'll tell you, it seems to me that you're going to be going a long, long way as far as that rung of ladder success is concerned in tag team competition.
Well, we got one thing in mind, and I guess everybody out there knows what it is. We want to capture the titles again, the tag team titles against Fuji and Tanaka. We'd like to be wearing those belts. I wore it before, and I feel real confident that Peter and myself can hold the titles.
Seems to me that more than ever, Peter, you and Jay have your team work together.
Well, we got our things together, and you know, since we the chief and I have teamed up, we've been very successful around the country, and we only have one thing in mind, and that is for the world's heavyweight, you know, the tag team heavyweight champion, and I'm sure that my brother here and I will be capable of going against the champions and be able to take that away from them.
Let's speak of the tag team champions, if we may, Fuji and Tanaka for a moment. Jay, what do you see that they have that you don't have? Is there any particular thing that they have together as far as teamwork or their aggressiveness?
They have the belts.
They have the belts. There's no question of that. As far as power is concerned, let's take a look at that department, although certainly...
As far as power is concerned, I think there's no doubt that I don't have the power, but I know my partner has.
You have a lot of power.
I don't think I can, as far as... this brute strength that likes the Tanaka and Fuji. I mean, I won't even try to match them power. I try to match him as far as maneuvers, but I know that Peter can match him as far as power, and they're concerned about that. It's a style that I think is going to confuse him. I think Peter and myself got styles that that's kind of hard to get accustomed to, and it's been working so far. We hope it keeps going.
As far as general conditioning is concerned, Mr. Maivia, should you somewhere along the way meet Fuji and Tanaka, for that matter, any other great tag team combination? And as far as general conditioning is concerned, do you think you're ranked as highly as Tanaka and Fuji are concerned, say maybe in an hour time limit?
Well, I think Strongbo and I are in the best of our condition right now, going against any team, especially the world's heavy, tag team champion. We have no doubt that these two men, they're a great wrestler in the world today. And that's why they are the champion. However, as I said earlier, that Jay and I are ready for any kind of action, brother.
Teamwork, let's talk about that. How do you compare yourselves favorably or unfavorably to Fuji and Tanaka?
Well, I think we got together more than they do. I think I care about Peter and he cares about me. And as far as Tanaka and Fuji are concerned, I really think they don't really have it all together like that, because they got Freddie Blassie, their manager. And Freddie Blassie is concerned about one thing, is money. And he goes to all extremes to make that money, and I think sometimes he might do things that irritate either one of them. I think with Peter and myself, we got in mind one thing, is that to go in there and win a match, win the titles, and that's it right there.
Peter, how do you compare, do you think, as far as versatility is concerned?
Well, you know, I don't understand what's a versatility. What is it?
Well, your different styles and what have you, your different holds that you have and Jay Strongbow has. Do you think you have more different holds than, say, your Fuji and Tanaka?
Of course, because we're scientific wrestlers, and Jay is one of the fantastic scientific wrestlers. And I'm not bragging about myself, because I've traveled around the world and I've wrestled many great wrestlers. Either I come on top or not, but it's an experience yet. And I think we're more capable of handling as a wrestling match itself. But when it comes to a drag-out thing, well, it's in our alley too. Right, Bob?
Right.
As far as progress is concerned, are you proud of yourself thus far as to where you are right now as far as rankings are concerned?
I'm just tickled pumped to death about it. I mean, there's no doubt about it. I'm just tickled to death. I mean, our record shows. I mean, I think we got it together, and that's the thing, is getting it together. And Peter and myself, I think we got it together. We kind of feel the same way, and we think the same way.
Well, sir, we'd like to wish you the very best of luck in your endeavors. Perhaps you will become tag team champions. At least we certainly hope you have the opportunity.
Thank you very much.
Peter Maivia and Honorary Indian Chief Jay Strongbow, we thank you for joining us. We shall return in just a moment.
Our ladies and gentlemen, this next contest is scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. But first, allow me to introduce that fearless manager of wrestlers, Captain Lou Albano. And here in the corner to my left, from Montreal, Canada, weighing 301 pounds, here is Butcher Paul Vachon. And his opponent from Panama City, weighing 220 pounds, it is Steve King.
We have the principal, Steve King, against the big butcher, Paul Vachon. Mr. Vachon, of course, one of the wrestlers in the stable of Louis Albano, and we're set for the action to begin. Steve King tangled in the ropes there, and the butcher has him right where he wants him. Yeah. Bashan continuing with his attack. We mentioned at the outset that Bashan is managed by Louis Albano, also in the stable of Louis Albano, the Golden Terra. And Ken Patera, who has been reinstated here in the Worldwide Wrestling Federation, although we haven't seen him for quite some time. We look forward to the return of Ken Patera. With a bit of reservation, of course, but nevertheless, Patera will be back. Albano, I don't know if you can pick up his antics around ringside, but whenever there's Lou Albano, there's always trouble. Bashan, at the moment, dishing out the trouble against his opponent, Steve King. King thus far has given Bashan very few, if any, problems. King again against the ropes, breaks it up, he works in the midsection, and the right hand to the side, oh, that time to the chin. King into the solar plexus, another left hand now arming on the back. Steve King spins his man around, and apparently has turned things around for himself, if only momentarily, although it looks like now it's time for consultation. Scheduled up later on, ladies and gentlemen, the Stand the Man Stasiak Larry Zbysko match is Bashan with a very nice takedown then. Takes Steve King down to the canvas. Butcher Paul Bashan hammering Steve King to the canvas. Again. The Butcher has very little, if any, mercy at all when he's in the ring, and no sense of fair play at all. That knocked a big bag of wind out there for a moment. Steve King again looking pretty good here against the Big Butcher at the moment. Has him by the whiskers now. King whipped to the ropes, waiting for him. Big Bashan and a foot right up into the chest. Bashan off the ropes and squash. Wow. One, two. I'm sure he can count to 100 if he wanted to after that. Bashan absolutely squashing Steve King. And thus, Bashan continues his undefeated streak thus far on All-Star Wrestling. If we may, let's get the official time.
The time of this match, 4 minutes and 6 seconds. The winner, Butcher Paul Bashan.
The Butcher cleaning his hands, making the gestures like, well, sir, there was no competition at all. Indeed, it was not. Bashan now holding her up for his manager, Louis Albano. Let's take a look. Let's go back in time here as Steve King is whipped to the ropes by the big Butcher. Up now with the foot right into the chest. From there, Bashan says he's going for it all the way. Imagine the impact of 300 pounds up that high in the air, squashing down into the chest. Bashan victorious, and we shall return with Larry Zbysko.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next contest is scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. But first, allow me to introduce that colorful Grand Wizard of Wrestling right there. And in the corner to my left, from Buzzards Creek, Oregon, weighing 287 pounds, it is the former Worldwide Wrestling Federation's heavyweight champion, Stan the Man Stasiak. And in the corner to my right, from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, weighing 250 pounds, introducing Larry Zbysko.
This should be quite a match. Stan the Man, the heart punch specialist, and we just may see the heart punch here, locking up with Larry Zbysko. Here we go. Unquestionably, Zbysko has turned things around for himself. Stasiak premature in attempting to deliver the hard punch. The hard punch is so devastating and unquestioned it's on the mind of every opponent of Stan the Man. And that's one of the reasons why Stasiak is so successful, because many times when the opponent of Stasiak is thinking of the hard punch, Stasiak can baffle him with a lot of versatility, and that's one thing Stasiak does possess. Stasiak able to defeat an opponent with almost any number of maneuvers. Although at this moment, it obviously seems as though Larry Zbysko has things well in hand. Stan the Man back to his feet. Oh, once again, Zbysko hooks him. Another capacity crowd here enjoying the wrestling. And I would say that the majority of them at the moment are enjoying what they're watching, as Larry Zbysko maintaining his control over Stan the Man. Stasiak off the rope and a shoulder block, able to tuck that elbow in this time, coming off and, oh, nice maneuver. Oh, yes, sir. The Grand Wizard looking on, look at him pacing back and forth. Can't figure out what's happening to Stan the Man. Why is it Stan the Man gaining the advantage? Zbysko, the only individual to have had the privilege of being trained by famed Bruno Sammartino, the living legend. Zbysko very proud of that. I might add, Bruno Sammartino very proud of Larry Zbysko. To the rope, shoulder block. Stasiak winning out on that exchange. Back again. Oh! Caught in midair. Hammered to the canvas. Zbysko once again in control and takes him down. Stan the Man is in a heap of trouble here. Can't figure out how to escape. Zbysko keeping his hold on the hammerlock there, keeping right behind Stan the Man. Not only does Zbysko emulate the style of wrestling of Sammartino, he looks very much like him body-wise. Off again, this time the knee of Stan the Man up and finds its mark. Stasiak doing the stomping. Here's the hard punch. Again, too premature. Stan the Man reaching the ropes. Referee Dick Worley must break it up. Looks like Zbyszko's going to break it up. All right. By now, that left arm and shoulder of Stan the Man must really be aching. The Wizard very much concerned, I'm sure, over the fate of Stan the Man at the moment, who does not appear to be the wrestler that Larry Zbyszko is. But just like that, Stan the Man turns it back around into his favor. A right hand again to the forehead. Zbyszko whipped through the ropes and out on the outside. Stasiak now with a handful of hair and jams the forehead again of Zbyszko into the corner pad. Right hand of Stasiak levels Zbyszko. Stasiak obviously keeping Larry, trying to keep him off guard, out of the ring for a permanent count out, and thus he'd get the Duke. Scooped up. Look what's happened. They're both out there. Zbyszko all over Stasiak. There may not be anything left of Stan the Man. The bell has rung, I'm sure. Whoa! Ray, that really turned into quite a melee. Let's get the time and the official word.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, in 6 minutes and 54 seconds, both men were counted out outside the ring. The referee calls the bout a draw.
An unpopular decision, but pretty much of a just one. Both wrestlers disregarding the official in the ring, and you just can't do that, not only in professional wrestling, but in any sport, for that matter, in life in general. We shall return, though, with a tag team match involving Fuji and Tanaka opposing Dewey Robertson and Johnny Rivera.
Ladies and gentlemen, here he is, that colorful, well-dressed manager of wrestlers, Fred Bellassie. On this next contest, it is a non-title tag team match. It is scheduled for one fall or two curfew. Here in the corner to my right, from Puerto Rico, weighing 221 pounds, it is Johnny Rivera. And his partner from Toronto, Canada, weighing 245 pounds, it is Dewey Robertson. And in the corner to my left, the tag team champions of the world, from Hiroshima, Japan, weighing 285 pounds, Professor Toru Tanaka. And his partner from Osaka, Japan, weighing 275 pounds, Mr. Fuji.
Fuji and Tanaka, along with their manager Fred Bellassie, as the tag team championship belts are handed to the attendant. Fuji and Tanaka taking their time and preparing themselves to wrestle, and we're scheduled for action. Professor bowing to the corner, throwing this out. Now ready to lock up. This is going to be most interesting to see what Tanaka can do with Dewey Robertson. Robertson obviously ready for what may have been not so clean break there by Tanaka. Robertson from behind there, applying a full Nelson on that massive neck of Professor Tanaka. Well, Tanaka with a nice escape, but Robertson held on and countered very nicely. Well, I'll tell you, that is one bull in there, that Tanaka. Quickly reaching for the ankle, nice takedown by Tanaka. Robertson back to his feet. Tanaka yanking on the hair, and the referee tapping Tanaka. Fuji, of course, you see in the corner now, double teaming. Robertson giving him what's for in that ring. Tag made, and Johnny Rivera through the ropes. Wide open for the Professor. Cannonball into the side. Rivera for the count. He has one, and that's all. Tanaka, what appears to be digging in the pectoral muscles. Tanaka resorting to the martial arts. That's certainly one of the advantages held by both Fuji and Tanaka, to resort to those martial arts at any given moment. Wide open Johnny Rivera, double oblique chop, sends him down on one knee. Fuji measuring Johnny Rivera down into the solar plexus in the chest area. Tag is made. Let's see what happens now as Professor Tanaka battles Johnny Rivera. Tanaka, if you can let it, if you'll get away with it, just to lean all that massive weight on an opponent. That in itself will attempt to wear an opponent down, and normally does a pretty good job of it. That plus the holds, the variety of which is really something to see here with Tanaka. Normally results in victory for Fuji and Tanaka. And it goes without saying, their cheating tactics and shortcut methods sometimes pay off in the short run. Over the hip again. Roundhouse right catches him, uppercut, attack made. Here comes Dewey Robertson. To the ropes, Fuji. Ooh. Once again, Fuji thrown to the ropes. Robertson, there's an abdominal stretch. Tanaka quickly breaks it up. Fuji in there against Johnny Rivera. Rivera hurled for the far side of the ring. There's that kamikaze clothesline. One, two, we have an easy three for Fuji after that hold. Yes, sir. The kamikaze clothesline. Once again, displayed on Champion All-Star Wrestling, and I'll tell you, it's devastating.
It is the time, 5 minutes and 34 seconds. The winners, tag team champions of the world, Professor Taru Tanaka and Mr. Fuji.
Fred Lassie very proud of Mr. Fuji and Professor Taru Tanaka, victorious once again. Let's take a look at it. If we have the kamikaze clothesline, here, ladies and gentlemen, there's the abdominal stretch that we saw earlier. Now, from there, Tanaka went on to break up what could have been victory for Dewey Robertson and Johnny Rivera. Fuji squaring off there against Johnny Rivera. Pound for pound, Rivera can go toe-to-toe with the best off. Now to the ropes. And Fuji, ladies and gentlemen, will put that devastating kamikaze clothesline right on Johnny Rivera and chalk up victory for this combat.